Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Lazy Admin. Today we are going to talk about how to configure Nagios agent for Windows. In the past video, we have already configured and installed Nagios server. And now we have to add a host for monitoring different matrices. So here we go. Let's head to one website first, that is nsclient.org. From here you can download the client. So this is the website. So here you can see we can download the latest build or the older version also. So here it goes. So we can basically download 0.5.2.35. So we'll click x64 because we have a 64-bit client, and it will start downloading the client. So as you can see, it's a 31.5 MB package, so it will download. So it has completed downloading, so we are going to run the setup. We can hit next. We are going to install generic NS client. Configured to work with monitoring system. This is another solution, OP5. We are not talking about this. We are going for generic. So we are going to hit install most of the programs or custom. Let's do custom and see what it is installing. We are not installing OP5, so that's it. Program files, yes, we are going to install that, documentation and script. So let's hit next. Okay, it will put the INI file here where it installs. Next. Okay, we are going to provide it with the server IP. So server IP is 0.115, and we have to provide it with one password. This is required. So for our lab sake, we are putting all passwords as passwords. So we are enabling NS client. So in secure and legacy mode, we going to old check NRP. So that's it, folks. We hit next. And we are going to install. Yes, we are installing it. So we have successfully installed the NS client. The rest of the part, the configuration, we'll do on the Nagios server. So here we are. We are back on the Nagios virtual machine. So now we are going to check the configuration. The configuration of the configuration file of Nagios suite to find out where actually is Windows configuration file. So user local Nagios etc, and we'll see here there is a file here, configuration file called Nagios.cfg. we're going to vi Nagios.cfg. so here we are going to find the configuration file for Windows. So if you can see here, there is a configuration file called cfg file objects windows.configuration. So we have one file for Windows, so I am going to uncomment this file, and here you go. So we'll save and exit. Okay, and cd objects ls, and you will find here windows.cfg. so we'll go here and configure this file. Let's see, the use is Windows Server, and the host name, I will change the host name and the alias. So I will do both. Okay, so I have to change this one. So down there in this file, you will find all the services that it has to monitor for this specific host. So if you look at here, so the service definition, so you will find a lot of service definitions that are going to monitor different matrices of this host. So probably you are going to change everywhere the host name. So you will change the host name everywhere on this file. So this is a hectic process. So I came up with a proper way. Just we can use a vi command to change wherever this win server, we can replace it with our host name. So let's do that. So we can see we have changed everything out there. Not everything actually. We did few configuration changes in the file of windows.cfg, and we restarted Nagios servers. And now we can see the Nagios server is running. So we'll head back to the GUI and check if our host is reporting or not. So we are back on the web browser, and we have opened our Nagios core server, and we'll click hosts, and we can see our host is reporting now to the Nagios server. We can click here. So basically it is reporting everything. The ping is okay and everything. So we have a list of commands here that we can use to disable some checks or enable some checks or customize some things. So we can do a lot of things in here. So this was it, folks. You have to install a Windows server or for a Linux server. The process is kind of the same. If you find this difficult or if you find this confusing, go and try Nagios 11 XI. You will find it a lot easier. There is a wizard on the web browser itself. You can just click and configure. So this is it, folks. Nagios core works like this, and this is how you install. I hope you have liked the video, and please don't forget to like and subscribe this video. Thank you very much, and have a very nice day.